sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Human magnetism. Beginning in the 19th century, there have been reports of people exhibiting strange magnetic qualities, often accompanied by unusual displays of electric energy. Scientists are at a loss for how to explain this phenomenon, although a number of cases have been studied and well documented. For example, for 10 weeks beginning on July 15, 1846, 14-year-old Angélique Cotton of France began repelling objects, some of them pieces of heavy furniture, away from her body through some unseen electric charge whereby they would jump or spin away from her, usually after she touched them. At the same time, the needles of compasses held near her would spin violently. While investigating her abilities on behalf of the French Academy of Sciences, physicist François Arago determined that Cotton's powers grew stronger as night fell and seemed to come from her left arm. He also noted that her pulse grew more rapid whenever she was displaying the phenomenon, and sometimes she would have convulsions during this period as well. Similarly, in 1890, 16-year-old Louis Hamburger of Maryland was studied by researchers of the Maryland College of Pharmacy because of his magnetic qualities. Metal objects would attach themselves to his skin so strongly that he could lift them off the ground. On one occasion, he lifted a 5-pound, 2.3-kilogram jar of iron filings that had attached itself to three of his fingertips. In 1976, 12-year-old Vivian Jones of England somehow became charged with electricity after breaking his arm, to the extent that he was able to illuminate a light bulb simply by holding it, and for 2 days his magnetism caused any watch brought near him to stop running. He could also give people massive electric shocks and make lights flicker and appliances turn on and off. The majority of people displaying such temporary abilities are adolescents, which has led some researchers to suggest that the same abilities are responsible for poltergeist activities, attacks on people, usually adolescents, that are often said to be caused by violent spirits. However, no one has been able to determine what might cause human magnetism, and skeptics are largely silent on the issue, except, on occasion, to suggest that fraud is involved. They do comment, though, on the use of magnets to improve human health, which is usually done under the belief that a human body undergoes certain changes when subjected to magnetism. For example, some believers say that magnets affect the iron in red blood cells, thereby improving circulation. In evaluating such cases, skeptics typically say that magnets have no effect on the human body whatsoever.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.